This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on Ezreal. We're going to continue working and try and finish up this chest piece here today, as well as probably try and finish up the sword on the shoulder pauldron. See if we can get a lot of this upper torso area done. What I want to show you guys first, though, is something interesting. I had mentioned in some of the previous videos about not knowing what to do with this shoulder pauldron at all. And I finally, after many internet searches, found an image of someone who had actually done something with this shoulder pauldron and taken a picture of it. And shockingly enough, it didn't come from the internet. It actually came out of a book that I've got. This is a book. I'll zoom out just a touch here. It's called Angels of Darkness. I'm sorry, Angels of Death. Excuse me. This is the old second edition codex for both Blood Angels and Dark Angels. You can see we've got a nice Death Company Marine there on the front. But in this book, the reason I pulled this out was because I was trying to figure out what color to paint the hilt of the sword on both the front here, as well as the side of the shoulder pauldron here, as well as on the back banner that you guys haven't even seen yet. Because I've seen so many different variations on it, but I really want to know specifically kind of what the GW style was, because I want to make it somewhat authentic. You know, I've seen people paint the hilt in various golds. I've seen them paint it in red, and that was kind of what I originally thought to do. But like I said, I'd seen so many variants, I wasn't really sure what I wanted to go with. So I pulled out this old book to see if I could find a picture of the banner specifically. And let me get the banner, actually. Hang on one second. Ugh. It is in a completely different area. It's over here. All right. Having a seat again. All right, so here's the banner. So let me zoom in again. All right, so you can see the guy's holding a sword right there. And I knew if I could find a good picture of the banner, I could easily tell what color the hilt of the sword was supposed to be, and then replicate that same color everywhere on the miniature that I saw a sword. So, I wanted a good banner picture. And for that, I turned to my ancient tome of knowledge, the Angels of Death. So, let me show you exactly what I found. All right, so here is an old, lost my place, how exciting. Let's see, here's some old pictures. Alright, so we can see a few banners here. You see in this instance, the hilt of the sword is actually black, and the blade is red. Here we've got the same thing. We've got a red blade and a black hilt. And over here, though, we have a red hilt and a red blade. Let me zoom in so you can see that, because that's kind of the unique one of the three. Let me show you that. Okay, there we go. All right. Oh, that was great. Thank you, Paige, for falling over. All right, so there's one. Let me show you a little bit more close on these others so you can kind of get an idea of them as well. I love these old books because they've got banners, and you can print them out, or you can copy them, I guess I should say, and have some really cool banners for your guys. So we got a couple different options there. This banner actually shows a silver blade with a silver hilt and a kind of a red handle, or a silver cross piece and a red handle. So there's some different options here, but it seems to be that the most common option is the red blade with the black hilt. And in finding, come on, camera, there we go. All right, so there we have a red blade with a black hilt. It's obviously reflecting some light there because it's got a little bit of gray highlight to it, and a little bit of gold right there on the pommel of the hilt there. But if you look at the models banner a little more up close, the other one is like a one you can kind of photocopy and just attach to your miniature. This was before they did pre-printed banners, so this would have been long time ago. But if you look at the miniature itself, if I can get to it, there it is, a little bit more up close, you see same thing, red blade, kind of grayish black cross piece, and sort of a golden hilt leading into what appears to be here more of a bonish color on this one. And I think that's because in the model's hand, you actually do have a skull here. Let me get the miniature back. I don't know if I'll be painting this in skull color. I think it might be an interesting thing to do, but I'll have to kind of approach that as we get to it. You can see, well, I'll show you in just a second. There's extra areas of the miniatures that have skulls on that are painted actually as skulls. So you have the belt buckle here, the gun itself, these skulls on the backpack back here. Very, very neat stuff. But again, in searching for this, excuse me, I noticed that there is a picture of that shoulder pauldron. And you can see here, they've simply drawn in another sword. But their shoulder pauldron is completely black, which I gotta tell you, I'm not a huge fan of. I do like the banner that says Azrael, although I'm a little skeptical about putting that there because you've already got this banner, the main banner of the model, that says Azrael. So, I don't know, you know? But I thought it was kind of neat to show you guys this after all of my work searching on the internet trying to find a decent picture or design of something on the shoulder pauldron, going back to the very, very first sourced piece that I remember ever seeing this miniature, it's right there. And it took me a long, long time to get back to this because I just wasn't thinking, I guess. What I also find interesting, what I was going to say is, you can see these, like these things, the skulls on the hands here, also done in the bone pattern up here on the gun as well. What I found interesting, though, is it shows this sword on the, what would that be? That would be the left shoulder pauldron, and it's actually painted white with a brown hilt. So, a lot of different options here, but I think I'm going to go with this most common sort of theme of, there we go, of the red blade with the black hilt indoor cross piece. Although I'm still waffling. I think this one over here is pretty good too, with the kind of golden, bony sort of color, and then the black indoor silver cross piece. Either black highlighted gray or just a little bit of silver there. So, again, don't know with certainty what we're going to do, but I wanted to show you guys that, pardon me, my goodness. I wanted to show you guys that a little image there, a set of images, because I thought it was kind of interesting that, like I said, after all of that searching with the modern day technology and internet and everything, and I couldn't figure out where a good picture was, I just had to go back to my original source, which made things incredibly easy. So, let's see. Am I roughly in frame for where I'll be painting? I am indeed. So let's do it to it here. We're going to start off by highlighting the... what are we going to highlight? We're going to highlight the robes of this little figure here holding the sword on the chest. So, let me get my mixing brush to where I can actually utilize it. And grab a little bit of white and mix it into my chocolate brown. I don't want a lot of highlight on this because this is not a standout area. I'm probably only going to put two highlights on there, if that many at all. I just want to establish that there are some shadows and a little bit of a little bit of contouring to that portion of his armor. That's really all I want to do. So, let's pull the string off the brush so that we can utilize it. And let's do this. I am in frame, which is awesome. We're just gonna place a few little strokes of paint in various areas, preferably the correct area. And then perhaps a little bit more white added to our color. Give us a little bit lighter highlight. I don't want to get it light enough to where it sort of clashes with the wings. They're already a nice bright feature right in the center there. And it's nice, if you can, to kind of alternate lights and darks with one another, right next to each other, because it just helps the areas of the miniature stand out more readily. So there we go. And let's see here. Figure maybe there-ish. Ooh, yeah, that's a good highlight right there. I like that one. Even painting in folds of a cloak that may not be there. How exciting. Alright, let's see here. Let's do a little here. A little on the outside. And a little over the top. Just a little off the top, sir. Right. There we go. I think I may add one tiny more highlight to it, just to give it some pop. Alright. We'll do this. Just down there towards the bottom. And then maybe a little on the hood up here. Okay. Maybe kind of on the little arms that are holding the sword. Again, just want to establish a few contours on this armor piece. Make it look somewhat three-dimensional. Now, we're going to mess it all up by putting on a black wash. And truthfully, I'm not sure how this is going to work. I tell you what, let's not do black. Let's use this. This will work better. It's dark. And it's not going to kill the color, hopefully. Let's find out. It's thick, though, so I'm going to thin it big time. Alright, let's try this. If it doesn't work, we can always go back and do it again. I really just want a good kind of dark color in some of these recessed areas here. Doesn't have to be everywhere. But here, in the folds of the cloak. There we go. Maybe even a little down here. A little bit there. That's a little better, I think. Let's see here. Can you see that? Can you tell what we've done there? There you go. Okay. Not too bad. Not too bad at all. So, the time has come. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's do the blade first. That'll be the easiest thing to do. Alright. I was going to say, the time has come to make a decision. But we don't have to make a decision yet. We got a blade to paint. Let's paint a blade. And for that, we will need some red. Varying shades of red. Alright. Okay, okay. So what kind of texture? None. Okay, great. I was trying to make her, trying to check and see what sort of, what's the word I'm looking for? I want to use the word topography, but that's not going to work for some of you, so, what sort of gradients, what sort of texture to the armor there was in these areas where the sword is. Because if there's a lot of texture, I got to start with a darker color. But since there's not a lot of texture, I can start much closer to my final color, which is great. and save me a little bit of work. Alright, so that really doesn't have the point of a sword, but at distance, it's not really going to matter. It really just looks more like a club or something than anything, but that's alright. I'm not going to fiddle with it. Okay. What I am going to do is paint this sword here. I see something that needs to be addressed. And that is, we need a slight green line to separate this blade from the wings on this side. So I'll do that before I put my highlights on, and that way if I mess up, I'll just cover it up with the highlights, and it won't be that big of a deal. Go. Need to get the sides over here as well. It's kind of tricky doing that. Okay. Now, let's see here. I need to kind of smooth that out. That's annoying me a little bit. Whoa! Whoa! Hello. Got a little bit of red where we didn't want it. Add it on the wing over there. That's okay. I've got a little white here on my palette, so we'll just pick that up. And touch that area up, and no one will be the wiser. Come on. Touch up properly. Ta-da. Okay. Now, do you see, potentially at least, the nice clean green line that we've got separating the wing and the sword on that side over there? It does not appear quite as clean on, where's my finger, this side. Like my side, over here on the left side of your screen. Over here. What I'm thinking is the left side of your screen. I don't know. Let's see. Over. Let's see this. Yes. No, it's the right side of your screen. Everything's backwards for me. Alright, so. I need a little green to fix that. Let's do that. Where's my green? Here we are. Oh my goodness. We're running out of time. I didn't realize it was so late. Man. I gotta stop jawing when I do these videos. That's just yakety 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 yak. But that's okay. Hopefully they're enjoyable. So, we'll paint this line to get things kind of cleaned up and then call it a day. And perhaps by next time, I will have decided what sort of hilt to put on this thing. Green or red or silver or gold or black or who knows. It'll be a surprise. We'll clean up there too. Okay. Now, I need to come in with a little bit of that red color. And just touch up this blade and get it ready for highlighting again. There's that. And then there's this. Right there. Okay. Well, I made a little bit of progress there. Not significant or anything, but I think enough to call it pretty darn cool. I love the way this, the direction this model is going. It's just really a neat miniature, and I think it's going to look super, super stellar once we get done. But we'll call it a video for right now, so hopefully you enjoyed it. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to drop those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you have not done so already. Again, I want to thank you very, very much for watching. God bless you all. Have an awesome rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.